Good afternoon, everyone. Today we have Professor Dr. H.P. Singh, VSM, who is the president of ICFA University, Jaipur with us. So, sir, we welcome you on behalf of College Duniya. Professor Dr. H.P. Singh is a distinguished academician, researcher, and educational administrator. He is currently the president of the ICFA University, Jaipur. A PhD from Andhra University, Visakhapatnam, and M.Tech from IIT Kharagpur, Professor Singh has been actively engaged in teaching, research, training, and consultancy for more than 38 years, and has been a distinguished policy advisor, trainer, administrator, and institution builder. He did his engineering in electronics and communication from Pune University, MBA from Osmania University, and MSc in defense and strategic studies from the Madras University. He has been the vice chancellor of ICFA University, Himachal Pradesh, for close to 3 years prior to the present appointment, and pro-vice-chancellor of NAC-A-accredited SDV University, Jaipur, in 2017-18. Prior to this, he was the chief executive officer of the Podaya Group of Educational Institutes in Rajasthan, which has 13 institutions covering the entire spectrum of nursery classes to postgraduate studies. He has served as director, research and projects in a PSU, Instrumentation Limited Kota, for 4 years and offered consultancies to various strategic organizations in the country. He was nominated as the Best Director, Research and Projects in the year 2015. Early during his association with the Indian Defense, he had led a number of delegations to Russia and Israel for deliberations on software-intensive systems for the strategic requirements of the country. Professor Singh has guided a large number of M.Tech projects, research scholars for doctoral studies in artificial intelligence, cloud computing, and strategic management, authored 2 books, and published a number of research papers of practical relevance in national and international journals of repute. He is a specialist in artificial intelligence, machine learning, and network security. He has organized a number of international conferences on cybersecurity and chaired technical sessions on contemporary topics. Professor Singh is a recipient of the commendation by Service Chief and Presidential Award, Vishisht Seva Medal, VSM, for his distinguished service of exceptional order to the nation. He is also the recipient of International Academic and Research Excellence Award 2019 and Icons of Himachal Pradesh Award July 2021. He is a fellow of the Institution of Engineers, FIE, India, and chairperson of a number of committees at the ICFA Group of Universities. We are glad to have you here with us at College Duniya. So, sir, being the VC at ICFA University, Jaipur, what is your philosophy of leadership and how would you describe your leadership style?
Thank you. Firstly, leadership in education sector is slightly different from the leadership in, let's say, the Indian defense or public sector. Education is a little different. And my style of leadership is a participative kind of leadership and transformative leadership. Participative from the point of view that I always take the stakeholders into account, the faculty, students, in any kind of decision making in the university, be it for the professional matters, academic matters, or the administrative matters. So my philosophy as the vice chancellor or the president of ICFA University Jaipur is to have a participative kind of leadership and a transformative one. Transformative from the point of view that the national education policy also talks about transformative kind of education, you know, space now in the few years to come, 5 years, 10 years. You need to have a lot of changes in the way you teach, you innovate, you research. So all that kind of things require transformative kind of leadership. And I have that kind of leadership style.
Definitely. When you first came to ICFA University, what was your vision for the university and how far have you achieved it?
Now, the vision of ICFA University is very clear. ICFA University wants to be the preferred location for all the students, prospective students, because it believes in value-based education. So when I joined ICFA University Jaipur, this has been a very recent one because it joined only in July 2021. But prior to that, I was with ICFA University Himachal for a good 3 years. And my vision has always been that we should have excellence in all activities, all spheres of activities of the university, whether it is academics or research. Our programs have to be innovative we have to have entrepreneurship in the programs, and we have to have the industry requirement taken into account in our curriculum and in our syllabi, so that we prepare our students for the industry. So the vision is to have a space like that where you also look at the students, and this university and equi universities are student centered. That means we have a lot of attention paid to the students, not only in their teaching, but for them, offering them club activities and any kind of decision making in the university. We always include their representatives to see that we get inputs from them. Finally, they are going to be the beneficiary of what we do. So that is what my vision is. And the vision is to see the EPI University as one of the center of excellence in the field of engineering, management and law.
That's great, sir. So as the Vice Chancellor, what are your responsibilities and roles towards the institute and the students?
Well, my responsibility as Vice Chancellor is the academic and administrative leadership. That means I am responsible, I am the head of academics, research and administration. So my responsibility also to the students is that we provide them a responsive and prompt administration that is a transparent and forthright administration, proactive administration, and at the same time provide them the best of academics, best of programs that we can offer. And so my responsibility, if you ask me, towards the institution is to see that I fulfill the requirement of vision of the university. I work towards vision and mission of the university and try to fulfill it with the support of my team of the faculties and meet the expectations and aspirations of our student community.
So what are some valuable insights into the programs that you're offering at your institute? Just like you mentioned, you want to be the most preferred institute by students in engineering, law and management. So what are the valuable insights that or a valuable takeaway that a student can expect from EPFI University, Jaipur?
Absolutely. Now, when you look at the programs, you see general programs of, let's say, engineering or BCA. What EPFI offers is based on the requirement of industry. For example, I would say in the engineering, we've got BCA Artificial Intelligence, BCA Data Science, BCA Cybersecurity. These are the requirements of the industry. So we try to make changes in our curriculum and our offering to meet the expectations of the industry and the corporate sector. Similarly, in case of management, we have a case study based method. Today, if you teach students just like normal we used to do earlier, lecture method, it does not become effective, because all that information is on your finger, basically on click of a mouse, and you have all the information to you. What is important is how to make your students learn, how to make them assimilate what is taught to them. So the pedagogies have to be different. They can't just be a lecture method. So what we have is, like project-based kind of thing, case study-based pedagogies, or role-playing pedagogies, or, project-based, interactive kind of a thing. So case study-based methods are very strong in case of EPFI universities. And the whole EPFI space, they have there is a research center in Hyderabad which deals with case studies. So our management students get to learn a lot of case studies. They learn the management, techniques and management skills through the case studies. So this is, in the programs, we have something innovative, something different. That is how, the EPFI university run programs are different from the normal program that are run by colleges. So that is the difference.
That's pretty great, sir. Practical learning is the new normal.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, sir, what would you like people to know about the university that they may not know now?
Well, EPFI University is not publicized the way other universities are done. We don't have any hoardings, we don't have any social media kind of advertisement and publicity. We believe that what we do is what should be known to the prospective students and to the environment. And we feel that students are the best ambassadors of this university. So we teach them everything, including not only the academics, not only the research, but also value system. We teach them how to be a good human being, how to be a good citizen. What are your responsibilities as a good citizen? And that is why you see in the National Education Policy, they are also promoting liberal arts, because they don't feel that engineering students should do only engineering. Engineering student, to be a complete student and a good citizen, he should also pursue studies in liberal arts and all. So our ambassadors are our students. So we make sure that our students are very happy. They are content with the way we teach, and they go to the environment and spread the message that you come and join ICFAI. And we take only these students who are good, who are keen to do, and who are keen to pursue studies seriously. And that is the kind of thing that, this university does, which is different from the normal universities, because we pay attention mainly on the students, and they are our ambassador, and they carry forward the message from the university.
That's great, sir. So last question for the interview. What suggestions would you like to give to the students who are going for higher studies?
Well, this is a very relevant question, because today our 10 plus 2 students who are passing out from the 12th have a huge responsibility on their shoulders. Many of our cases, like in Rajasthan and all, the parents leave everything to the student that you do what you want to. Now he has got a lot of confusion in his mind. There are so many universities, so many colleges, so many, where does he go? What does he pursue? So my advice and my recommendation to prospective students is that kindly follow your interest, your aptitude, your passion. If you like mathematics, go for mathematics. Don't look for doing engineering, or don't look for doing pharmacy. You should do what interests you, because finally, that is what is going to interest you. That is where you're going to do well. So if you are interested in medical, you must make sure that you go to medical. And then look at the institutions that are available. Once you decided, okay, you're going to pursue, let's say, political science, then you make up your mind that I will do political science or I'll do arts. And then you look at the institutions. And the institutions have got their websites where all the details are available. Today, even the websites have got, the AI assistant, which can also reply you in real domain. You don't have to wait for the info to, come out as a print or as a, something can be seen. It can reply you online, that kind of thing also there. So I would say to the prospective students that keep your options. As far as pursuing studies is concerned, go by your interest, go by your passion. As far as the institutions are concerned, look at the kind of infrastructure they have, the kind of team they have. I would like to tell you, in ICFAI, we have the faculties who are from the, institutions of excellence. For example, IITs. I am from IIT myself. I think, I don't know whether in the biodata it was there or not. I done my postgraduate from IIT Kharagpur. And there are a lot of IITians here in the faculties. They are professors from NLUs. They are professors from IIMs. So you have the faculties from the best of the institutions from the country. So they should look at the faculty, they should look at the infrastructure where they have, the academic infrastructure, research infrastructure, the sports, the accommodation, the campus, the environment, all these things. They should look at it from the website, or they can visit the the campuses. I would say that keep the option of ICFAI University Jaipur in mind, because this is one of the best private universities around, and it will offer you what you're looking for, and it will make your dreams come true. It will ensure that your dreams are realized, your aspirations are realized. So that is all I can say about the prospective students.
So thank you for sharing your insights on the topics and on the questions asked. And on behalf of College Dunya, I'm really thankful to you for taking out time from your busy schedule. And it was really great getting to know about ICFAI University and what vision you hold for ICFAI University.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much.